Goldy, as countries around the world reveal their plans for reopening the economy, in a most recent letter to the Prime Minister, what are you hoping Canada's plan for reopening will look like?
Really, one that gives Canadians hope as to what changes once we've been through our vaccination process, whether it's one or two. What can Canadians expect? How do they get their lives back? And secondly, can we coordinate this better than perhaps we have on some of the other things over the last 13 months so that there is some consistency across the country? It would be very odd, for example, if you had, you know, your train running through one province but being told it can't go through another. Let's make sure that we have some consistency on our border policies, on our return to work policies, on the use of our public transportation system. You know, I applaud the fact that governments are starting to show us some of these plans. Saskatchewan has come out. Quebec, I believe, is on the verge of coming out. And the federal government, to its credit, on last week on Friday, put out some elements of what people can expect and not expect in this summer versus last summer. But I say with respect that they put a lot of the emphasis on sort of the public interaction that, you know, you can go hiking and you can meet some people from different families. We've got a lot more at stake here. We've got an economy at stake here. And what we're looking for is a nationally coordinated plan that provides Canadians with some confidence and clarity as to when they can go back to work, when they can be mobile again. And we want to make sure that there's incentive to get these vaccines. And I think we can get them well across the 70, 80, 90% if we tell people what the benefits are to them in terms of what the future looks like. So that's all we're really calling for. Let's work together and figure out how we can get this new normal underway sooner rather than later.
When you take a look at some of the other countries that perhaps ahead of us, the UK and the four-stage, I guess, rollout or framework that they have laid out, what is it that we can learn or take from them? What elements do you like? What elements do you think that perhaps need some tweaking?
Well, first of all, I like that they have a roadmap, that they're able to present a map that says this is what it's going to look like. And we're seeing that even in the case of the United States, if you don't communicate properly, like the CDC came out, the Center for Disease Control came out and basically said, oh, don't worry about wearing masks. Well, that caught the business community in the United States completely off guard to say, we're trying to ensure that there are, you know, public safety measures in place because we don't know who's been vaccinated. We don't know if people are going to still be moving around because there will be people who for some reason or another won't get vaccinated. And so the need for coordination is the lesson here. Government and business working together in the national interest and in the public interest will go a long way to build back public confidence. The other thing I think that most Canadians are looking for is some sense of the ability to plan down the road. I'm not calling for the border to be open this afternoon. What I'm saying is tell us under what conditions you're going to be opening the border for more normal travel. Can Canadians start planning a vacation in the summer? Can they plan for a vacation in Christmas time? Can business travel restart so that we can go out and meet our employees in other places in the world? And as you know, Canadian businesses are all over the world here. What are the rules going to be for people who've been vaccinated? Are quarantines still necessary if you've been vaccinated twice? And I think that only through a collaborative partnership where we can communicate clearly to Canadians, here's why we're asking you to get vaccinated. Here's how your life gets better because you're vaccinated. And here's what we're going to do to keep you safe because we know that we need to keep you safe. The pandemic doesn't end just because you're vaccinated. And there, I think we need to do a better job, you know, making sure we're pushing out not only the social behaviors that are necessary, but the use of rapid screens, I think, is something that Canadians are going to see is going to be a part of their lives in many parts of our workplaces and our entertainment industry in particular.
I think Canadians can all appreciate that we would all like to see the reopening of the economy, businesses get back on their feet. How optimistic is all of this? Are we getting ahead of ourselves here?
No, and as I said, let's be clear, we're not asking for this to happen, you know, by the end of the day. What we want is some benchmarking and some plans that says, you know, on such and such a date, like we saw in Saskatchewan, for example, you know, they put out a three-tier plan on three different dates. And as I said to the premier privately, it's okay if you miss the date. But at least, you know, if you have to push it out a week or 2 days or whatever, or even a month. But at the end of the day, what Canadians know is, at least people in Saskatchewan know, is here's what we're working towards. That if we do our part, get vaccinated, help prevent the spread, make sure that if you're positive that, you know, you quarantine and you isolate yourself and don't do the spread, use rapid screens to help prevent, spread that is happening, unconsciously by the parts of those who are walking around asymptomatically, not even knowing. All of these things give people a reason. They give them some hope that something is going to change. The other thing from a business perspective, Larysa, and your listeners know this, is planning is key here. Take the airline industry and others. You don't just take the plane and drive it onto the runway and take off tomorrow morning. We have to know how much time is available to get the people back to work and to get the equipment, the safety screen and all of those things that need to happen. Let's create some confidence and certainty that on X date or Y date or on Z date, these are things that Canadians can expect. And let's do what we can to make it as consistent as possible. That is so key from a business perspective. Imagine being an essential business or even a non-essential business, and you're a national business, and you're told that you can open in BC, but you have to be closed in, Manitoba, but you can open in Quebec, but you have to be closed in Nova Scotia. It almost seems unfair to your employees to be able to told that depending on where you live, you're going to be subject to different conditions. There has to be a collective benefit to being vaccinated. That's what we've been trying to do. And I don't know what else Canadians can do except get their vaccines, not once, but twice. And then they're expecting something. And we better put something in the window as to why that's the case, because otherwise we may, go the other direction. Right now, I think we're going to have tremendous vaccine uptake. I wouldn't want it to stall because people are realizing, well, hang on a minute here. I'm not getting much in return for my part of getting vaccinated. Let's give them a reason.
I've heard you mention back to work a few times. What are you hearing from the business community? What does that back to work model look like?
I think what you're going to see is a phased in approach on a number of things. Different companies and different organizations will try different things over a period of time. The summer is a good chance to do some trial and error. But I know that many are working towards a full on return for September. Some may be required to go back to work. I mean, Jamie Dimon over at JP Morgan in the US has basically told us people get back to work. Like, this is what the new life looks like. You've been vaccinated. We have to live with this thing. It's becoming endemic, but it's like a flu now, hopefully, for most people who've been vaccinated. So there's that expectation. And there's others who are saying, hey, let's try some other things here. We'll do some kind of a hybrid model. But we're going to get our kids back to school. We're going to get our kids back into universities and colleges and so forth. We have to give them that sense of confidence that September, good reason to believe September, most Canadians would have been long vaccinated with their two vaccines. Certainly, I believe that will be the case. I think we will achieve pretty high take up. The numbers on hesitancy are down dramatically. More and more Canadians are seeing the benefits of getting vaccinated. We should get our downtowns back. I mean, it is a war zone in most downtowns across this country. Barron, where is everybody? Let's bring them back and give the dates as to when that will happen. Make sure that our subways and LRTs are safe for people. Make sure that our buses are safe, because public transportation is going to be a very key element. But that means business, government, and our public sectors working together to reassure Canadians that, Canada's economy is back. Means it's also safely back, and that you can re-engage with society. But this is where, again, the message of getting vaccinated is important, because it tells Canadians there's a reward for being vaccinated. And the reward can't be I can go hiking, or fishing or whatever the case might be, because I did that last summer anyways, and I wasn't vaccinated. What about the real reward, which is for people to be able to get back to work, to be able to re-engage, to go out and enjoy some entertainment indoors as well as outdoors? That's what people want to know. And all we're saying to government is let's work together to develop that plan and give them that hope.
Do businesses still have a plan B, a contingency plan to scale back should we see a spike in transmission?
Now, this is where I think the use of rapid screening is going to be really, really important. Obviously encouraging people to get both their vaccines is going to go a long ways. And we should be seeing these numbers, particularly in our ICUs units, come down as those things happen. Business's primary objective, first and foremost, with or without a pandemic, is the safety and well-being of their employees and their customers. And so there's a fiduciary duty to that. They will continue to do that. But I think that what we're also seeing here is a real concern about the overall supply chain for many of these businesses. The large businesses, for the most part, were able to successfully pivot. They had the technology, they had the capacity, they had the know-how from their global operations to know how to do that. And that helped keep unemployment down. I mean, we peaked at around 15%. We're about half that now, slight bump last month. But we fully expect that we can get the jobs back. We're worried about, frankly, the SMEs. We're more concerned by all of those businesses that have become bankrupt or don't have any lifeline at the other end here. And we know that the government programs are going to have to be pulled back at some point in time. And the best way to pull back on those programs is to make sure that those businesses can restart in some way, shape, or form, including, you know, taking the leap one more time and opening up a business with the hope that they can make a go of it at this time. That's the only way back, Larysa. And all we're saying is let's work together to make that possible.